For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
The Global Migration Indicators report by the International Organization for Migration is here with an update on how COVID-19 affected migration around the world. The report says more than 2,300 migrants died while trying to get into Europe or within Europe in 2020. A majority of the migrant deaths in 2020 were in Europe. While the pandemic restricted mobility and reduced international migration, still there were 281 million international migrants in the middle of 2020. That is close to 4% of the world's population. In some parts of the world, migration went up despite travel restrictions along with deaths of migrant workers as well. For instance, 880 migrants died while trying to get into the Spanish Canary Islands, a big jump from 200 deaths at most in any year. Migrant deaths dramatically increased in Latin America as well. Worldwide, 3 million migrants were stranded by pandemic-related mobility restrictions in 2020, according to IOM estimates. But COVID-19 is not the only reason for the migrant crisis. Forced displacements have doubled over the last decade. 40.5 million people across 149 countries were newly displaced by disasters during 2020 alone, most of which were triggered by conflict and violence. The conflict in Syria, in South Sudan, in Ukraine, the crisis in sub-Saharan Africa, the Rohingya migration to Bangladesh, the crises in Yemen and Venezuela were the worst. Forced displacement increased, but 1.5 million fewer people sought refugee status in 2020. The report attributes this to people stranded by COVID and unable to seek help. Surprisingly, remittances were projected to fall 20% last year, but the decline was only 1.6%. Migrant workers sent home $540 billion despite the pandemic and economic slowdown. It appears many people send their savings to their families during the year. Global remittances are still higher than foreign direct investment and overseas development assistance combined. Despite their economic contribution, the world is less accepting of migrants than in 2019. The United States expelled over 600,000 people during the pandemic. Over 30% of its doctors are foreign-born and were crucial during the pandemic. Australia, Canada, and the United Kingdom expelled fewer people than in earlier years. The UK has over 33% foreign-born doctors too, apart from other critical health workers. Another big contributor to migration, environmental disasters. 7 million people in 104 countries were displaced due to natural disasters by the end of 2020. Afghanistan, India, Pakistan, Ethiopia, the Philippines, and Sudan had the most such people. In conclusion, the report says nations must integrate migrants and their concerns into their sustainable development goals, especially to fund massive data gaps. One of its recommendations is to mobilize additional financial resources for developing countries.